This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your host, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
No, we're looking for evil guys.
What the voice is
people must be heard.
Bigot, rape, and discrimination. The crime which are weakening on the
first I give you a warning. Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
Hey everybody, welcome to the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. I'm Jay, and this sad, sorry-looking motherfucker over here is my co-host and lovely assistant, Casey.
What's up, everybody? Yeah, I'm fucking sick today. I'm like, ugh. So if I sound like I'm talking through like a toilet paper roll, I'm sorry. I'm just, I feel like Casey Anthony's kid today.
Oh my God.
So I apologize if I feel like shit. I got toilet paper here, you know. And my hand lotion, no, just joking, but I got toilet paper here in a trash can next to me because I'm just going to be sneezing and blowing my nose all fucking episode probably, so I'm sorry.
With a nose that big, he's going to use that whole fucking roll of toilet paper too.
I'm not joking. I've been through like, this is like my third roll since last night. Like it really hit me last night. Like I had a sore throat and stuff, and last night I was playing WoW, and I'm like, got to get stuff done before reset, and I it was really hitting me.
So, yeah, I was thinking about trying to do the show without him, and then I realized he's the vanity of my white, so.
Yeah, the show must go on.
The show must go on.
Yeah, but in other good news, I won my fantasy football league.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, won $120.
That you'll never see, because nobody ever pays.
Oh, actually, I only have one person left. Yeah. Ashley. No, I'm just joking. Sorry to call you out like that. Take your time, honey.
But really.
Yeah. Regular season, I finished 5-9, made the playoffs, scored over 100 points in every game in the playoffs, and beat the first person place. It's going to be a long episode. I'm so hopped up on amphetamines. And
amphetamine? What are you, let me kill, mister?
Yeah, and medicine, and now I'm going to add alcohol to it, so why not?
Why not?
Yeah, and speaking of alcohol, our beer for today is a New Belgium Fat Tire Amber Ale.
Hey, let me play the thing. Let me play the thing.
That is a good sample. I love it. let me show. I got a label here for you for people that want to see it. I've been hearing a lot about this. It's at the bar that I normally go to and everything like that. I have a couple friends that like it, so I've been wanting to try it. I like that label. It's cool. It's like, you know, back in the day where they put baseball cards in your tires and everything like that. So, yeah, let's go ahead, I guess, and try this shit.
Give it a sample.
Cheers.
Sample.
If I can taste it.
Eh.
I can't taste it.
So it's up to me to do the rating then. Yeah,
I can't taste it at all. I'm sorry. This is horrible. Is it malty? Is it hoppy?
It doesn't really taste like much of anything.
Really? Are you sick too?
A little bit. But
all I can taste is just my mouth getting wet.
It's kind of sweet.
Really?
It's really carbonated.
Damn, I've been wanting to try this for a long time. I should have picked it when I wasn't sick.
Yeah, it's not exciting at all. It's,
really?
I mean, it's not horrible. It's not bad, but I certainly wouldn't go across the street for it.
Is it smooth at all, or is it?
No, yeah, it's nothing.
Really?
Very mass-produced tasting. Very.
Oh, really?
It's not at all.
Is it, what's that word? Like a summer beer?
Yeah, you know, you could sit and drink a bunch of these hanging out with your friends, but I think there's better options available.
Oh, really? Okay, well, since I can't taste shit right now, I was going to rate it out of Princess Leia hair buns. How many Princess Leia hair buns would you give it?
I'm going to go two.
Really?
Two Princess Leia.
It's not bad.
Yeah, it does. And the Cinnabons glued to her head.
Yeah, I can't taste it at all. I just don't know. Like, it tastes like moisture to me.
It's not much better when you can taste.
Really?
It's not that good.
Okay, well, that sucks. I'm going to have to try it when I'm not sick next time.
It's not bad. It's not going to, you know, offend your sensibilities, but it's certainly not going to excite you at all.
That Yards American Ale or whatever.
American Pale Ale.
Yeah, does it taste like that at all? Is it that smooth?
No, it doesn't. It's not even that exciting.
Really? Okay.
It just, it's a little bit of malty. It's kind of like a very watered down like an ESB, but okay. very watered down, very, very light English style brown ale, maybe. Okay. But it's like Newcastle mixed with club soda. It's Ugh. Not at all exciting.
Yeah, I'm glad I can't taste it.
yeah, it's not bad. It's not.
Or maybe it's
because
I'm not
out.
Sick. Maybe it just doesn't taste like anything.
It really doesn't. It's not all exciting.
Okay, so moving right along, what do you have for us today, Jay?
Well, hey man, did you see the New Year's Eve special to rock in the year?
No, I actually fell asleep right through because that's when I started getting sick, and I was sitting there playing WoW. And I was doing a dungeon or something like that, and I looked at the clock, and it was like 12:30. I was like, oh, shit, I missed the ball drop. I completely forgot about it.
Yeah, well, we always watch it, and kids stay up. We make a thing of it, you know. Hors d'oeuvres, and we do the sparkling grape juice and shit to make them.
Was your wife's cheese ball there?
No, cheese ball.
Oh, man. Jay's wife makes the greatest cheese balls. It's like... I don't know. It has all sorts of like cream cheese, nuts, and stuff. I'm lactose intolerant, so I shit like a demon afterwards. But it is worth it. She puts like chip dried beef in it. Ugh.
And she got the recipe from her stepdad. That's where got it from, and then she kind of like improved upon it.
Oh, it's delicious. Oh, she should package that shit and sell it.
Oh yeah, that's right. Really... yeah, everybody enjoyed that.
I told you guys, I'm very sorry. Like I'm gonna try as much as I can to turn my head, but. I'm so used to being all right.
So anyway, back to the subject at hand. I was watching that, and Mariah Carey just fucking botched her performance.
Yeah, I heard about that. Did she lip sync or what was
well,
going on?
Yeah, you pretty much have to at that sort of an event. She didn't lip sync per se, but she had a backing track.
Yeah.
And what happened? I guess I was calling her a diva and shit all through it because she was noticeably angry. Right. She was frustrated. And she was, like, talking shit on the stage, like, well, we didn't get a sound check, you know.
Was this being recorded, or did they
this was live.
She was, like, flipping shit right on TV.
She didn't flip shit. She actually handled it with a fair amount of grace for Mariah Carey. But she couldn't... What happened is the in-ear monitors didn't work, so she couldn't hear her backtrack, so she had no idea where she was, what she was supposed to be singing.
She's like, shit, I don't write these songs. I don't know the lyrics to my own songs. I don't write them. Some guy in Austria does or whatever.
Yeah, I mean, even beyond that, even if she did, if you can't hear where you're at, you can't do it.
What is that? We were talking about that one time. Like, one guy in Sweden or something is responsible for, like, 90% of the pop music that's written today.
Oh, yeah, Max...
you were telling me about that someday. He writes everything. And that's why, like, all pop music sounds the same. Because they hire this one guy, and he writes it, gives it to him. That's why, like, a lot of people make fun of country music, but I like Toby Keith because he writes his own music, and he started a record label that, you know, he only signs people to it that writes their own music, so it's nice to see that.
Yeah, he's a Swedish guy. His name is Max Martin. His actual name is Martin Carl Sandberg, but his like, normal name, whatever you would call it, his stage name is Max Martin, and he writes, like, everything.
That picture of him is priceless. That is the most slimy producer... look like you could ever give someone.
But he did everything. Like, let me see if I can bring up just a list of it. I Want It That Way from the Backstreet Boys, Millennium from the Backstreet Boys, Teenage Dream from Katy Perry, We're Never Getting Back Together with Taylor Swift, Roar from Katy Perry, Red from Taylor Swift, Shake It Off, Blank Space, Can't Feel My Face, 1989, Beauty Behind the Madness, Love Me Like You Do, you know, he was a producer of all this shit. He won awards for all these things. It Hit Me Baby One More Time. It's Gonna Be Me. I Kissed a Girl and I Liked It. So What? From Pink. My Life Would Suck Without You from Kelly Clarkson. California Girls from Katy Perry. I mean, everything.
No wonder pop music sucks. One fucking guy's doing it.
Yeah, he does it all, you know? I mean, everything. He's done so many different songs, and you know, it takes a team of writers to repeat four lines over and over again.
Yeah, that's what, because someone was saying that one time they showed like Beyonce's lyrics and what like Queen wrote or something. It was all like lovey-dovey and shit like that, and what's her name, Beyonce's song was like fucking one word repeated over and over again.
If you like it, then you better put a ring on it.
Yeah, it's like, oh fuck that, whatever.
So anyway, Mariah Carey, I think some people in her entourage are saying that the people who put the show on did it on purpose to make her have a meltdown, because Mariah Carey's kind of known for those diva moments.
Really?
I don't know if there's any reality to that. I can see him doing that, but really, would you want to sabotage your own show?
I know. And I maybe, I don't know. People are fucking bitter. Like, she probably did something like... She, like some guy or like got her coffee or something like that and didn't have cream. She like threw it in her face and she's like, I said I want piss in my coffee. And he's like, I'll show you.
Well, to be fair, she is kind of horrible.
Yeah. She still terrible. Looks good though. I see that picture of her.
Yeah. She's 47, 46, something
God
like that.
Damn, man. I drink her bath water.
Imagine how much, you know, how good you'd look if you could afford all that plastic surgery.
Yeah, I know. Shit. That's what I'm saying. She has to. She looks flawless right there. Her mm-hmm. titties are too round.
Titties are too round, face too high up, although she's yeah. starting to get that bulldog jowl thing.
Oh, really? It's probably from all that dick sucking. You don't get that far in show business from not putting dicks in your mouth, men or female.
Well, the chick's got some range. You got to give her that. But yeah. She, you didn't see it on the show because she was not singing. She's standing there like this. She's like, all right, I'll let the crowd sing, because they could hear the music. She couldn't.
Oh, that's what she did? I got to watch it. I didn't see it. Yeah, I didn't watch it at all.
She did one of those. She said some snide things like, you know, we didn't get a sound check. I guess that was what happens, you know. And then she said, you know, it's a holiday. I wanted a holiday too. Why can't I get a holiday?
So this is what ruined her holiday.
Well, when you come and you're supposed to perform in front of millions of people and you can't do it because your equipment's failing, yeah, that kind of ruined your holiday a little bit.
Yep. It's like impotence, you know, trying to have sex, enjoy your holiday, and, you know, your equipment fails. Just don't pay attention to me. I am all hopped up. Like the DayQuil wasn't working, so I fucking put a tack in those pills and just snorted the liquid. Oh my God, sorry. Yeah, see. We'll make this. We'll make this. Jesus Christ. Okay, I'm good. All right.
Are you done having things fly out of you at a rapid rate of speed?
Actually, my screen looks pretty clear, so I don't think anything. I have backups of cough drops and everything like that.
I should have put like a wall between us.
Yeah, like one of those curtains. You should have just worn a mask.
Yeah, I should have worn a fucking, like, well, like the Japanese people wear one of those masks.
Yeah, I can't really that hear how really... I sound. Do I sound nasally?
A little bit.
Really?
It would have sounded real good on the camera. Hey,
man, you got to do what you got to do. When SARS was breaking out, that's what they did in China.
Yeah, well, if I were you, I'd definitely attack that microphone with a little bit of Lysol later on.
Yeah, I know. This thing probably is fucking... Do you remember that episode of... Oh, shit, what was it? Fucking Fry.
Futurama,
yeah. Where he buys a gas station sandwich or something, and it has, like, a colony, and he starts a world on it. Do you remember that episode?
Yeah, you got a world starting on your microphone, on your windscreen.
New world. Oh, my God.
Speaking of Fry and Futurama, did you see the live-action thing, the fan-made film that came out? That's pretty good. Damn, where's my notepad? Write myself a note. I'll put a link in the description. Put a link to it on Twitter. It's pretty good. Some fans made a Futurama episode, and it was all live action and shit. It was pretty cool.
Oh, that's pretty badass. Yeah, that's I love live action shit. That's why I can't wait for the Power Rangers movie.
God, you're a nerd.
Yeah, who gives a fuck, dude? Alpha, you know, Zordon or whatever the fuck his name was.
You know, that was like three different shows that they all put together to make one show.
What's that, Power Rangers?
Yeah, the original one.
Oh, really? Yeah. Like, they just couldn't, like, decide on which one to use, so they're just like, fuck it, let's put it all together.
There was a bunch of those shows in Japan at the time that had, you know, the colorful people in the helmets and shit. Like, yeah, and they put them all together into one show, and then they took, like Rita was this space witch thing. She was from some other show.
Yeah.
And the monsters were from other show. And then they put in some more stuff just to make it into a coherent
story. Dude, I thought it was creative as shit. Like, hold on, I'm going to wipe my nose. Sorry, everyone. Oh, man. I don't want more...
This is why we're on the internet, because you can't get this kind of quality entertainment on television.
Yeah. I'm glad you guys are paying attention, but I thought it was interesting as shit, especially because I remember being little and watching Rita, and she makes her... I remember her making her monsters by, like, putting clay on cookie sheets and baking them. You remember that?
Yeah, they're like evil Shrinky Dinks.
Yeah, and I was like, that is so creative. I thought that was so cool. And I still remember the Putty Patrol. They were like, oh, you remember they made that noise?
I didn't really watch much Power Rangers.
Oh, I did. Yeah, I remember you were talking about it. You were like, I missed it by 1 year.
Yeah, I was 1 year older than you, and it was 1 year for me to think, eh, that's lame.
Yeah, I think that's...
Same with Barney the Dinosaur. I escaped that one.
Nah, really. I never watched Barney. Fuck that.
I was all about Mr. Rogers.
Yeah, Mr. Rogers is a badass dude. He's actually from Pennsylvania.
Mm-hmm.
And he... We went to a training, Pittsburgh Pirates. Oh, my God. It's going to be a long day. Pittsburgh Steelers training camp, and Mr. Rogers, the field was named after him or something, wasn't it? Because he put a lot of money into this school that they practice on. They practice.
It's the field at St. Vincent's. I don't know if they named it after.
Remember there was a sign that said Mr. Rogers Stadium or something. I forget what it was.
I don't remember.
Man. Yeah, he was a fucking badass.
I was too busy fanboying over everything.
Yeah, me too. Nah, I don't know. I'm excited for the Power Rangers movie. I can't fucking wait. I think it's the show where I got my first boner, but, you know. And that's like Jay. He showed me iZombie.
Love that show.
Yeah, and what's the girl's name that plays?
Oh,
I don't know her name, but she's fucking cute as fuck. And I was, like, looking her up, you know, fanboying and shit. I was like, oh. Then I found out she was a yellow Power Ranger. And I was like, Jay, she used to be a Power Ranger. And I started
You have a thing for accents, too. And then, Rose McGowan, that's her name. Or Rose McGowan, McIver.
Oh, okay.
It's Rose McIver.
She's so cute. Oh, yeah, and the accent.
Yeah, she's from New Zealand.
Yeah, the accent just gets me. And then, like, I found out she was a Power Ranger. And I'm like, Jay.
Some New Zealand babes, you know.
Yeah, I know. I was like, Jay, I can't do the show tomorrow. I have to go and buy some lotion, some candles, get some Barry Manilow going. I have a lot of work ahead of me.
I think she looks pretty good in the zombie makeup. But,
yeah.
Not so much without it.
Yeah. I don't know. I like her both ways. I really don't care. Like, I know the one episode she tried to be a scientist or something. She brought the accent out again. I was like, yeah, baby. And I heavy petted myself for about 2 hours.
Yeah, I was all about Lucy Lawless back in the day, man. Xena the Warrior Princess. I mean, I know her and Gabriella were getting it on, but
yeah, whatever, dude.
There was so much sexual innuendo between those two.
Dude, I love that show. That show was nuts, man. She just fucking run in there with that circle blade, just fucking start throwing it and just do that chant.
Sam Raimi directed that shit, you know.
Oh, did he really?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. I know.
Bruce Campbell was in it, too.
Was he?
Yeah, he was.
He probably made guest appearance.
Well,
anything Sam Raimi
does.
He
was a reoccurring character.
Yeah, anything Sam Raimi puts in, he puts Bruce Campbell in. Like, he was the doorman in one of the Spider-Man movies. He actually, he was in all three Spider-Man movies, I think.
God, I cannot remember how to pronounce his name. Autocles, I think it was. He was the King of Thieves, is what he was. He was a reoccurring character. He was in quite a few episodes.
I do remember that now. Okay. Yeah, he was the comic relief. Okay.
Well, you're thinking of Joxer. That was Ted Raimi.
Oh, okay. But I do remember, like, this thief guy coming in. Was he, like, clumsy or something?
No, you're definitely thinking of Joxer.
Okay. I remember, like, a clumsy guy or something.
Yeah, he was a thief, but he wasn't a very good thief. But he was only in some episodes, but he wasn't in a lot of them.
Uh-huh.
Joxer was in a lot of them, and that was Ted Raimi, which is Sam.
Is that
Raimi's
a Hercules
brother.
And Zeno?
Yeah, it's a wiki.
There's a wiki for everything, dude.
Oh my god, yeah.
And I just saw that they're low on money or something. Did you see that?
Oh, Wikipedia. They're just running their annual pledge drive. They refuse to put advertising on it, so they ask people for money.
Okay, because I saw that and I was like, they have a Wikipedia for everything. How are they low on money? But it's just, you know, to keep it going every year.
Yeah, because they don't put advertising. This is from Wikia or whatever.com.
Oh, okay. That's good. Stick it to the man.
You are all high on
coffee, I know. Listen.
All right, what do you got?
Well, I was talking to you about you yesterday. I got a picture over here. I'll bring it up real quick. But a while ago,
God, look at that ad going on in the corner. Fuck your story. Let's talk about that ad.
What's that say? Must read. Nurse fired for tagging friends on this video. Woman Bloop. Drops his stomach on man. That's Bloop. A thing.
Bloop.
That's a thing.
Bloop. Yeah, apparently so.
I gotta try that. I want some fantasy football money. I wonder how much that costs. How can that be satisfying to someone? I don't get it.
I don't know. It's the same thing as all those fucking 1,000-degree glowing knife videos. They're satisfying to people.
I know. I saw something the other day. They're like, what would cut butter quicker? a sub-zero temperature knife or a hot butter knife?
Dude, we need to start like clickbaiting that shit.
I told you process porn. We covered that like the third or fourth episode, didn't we? Or maybe the second, I think it was.
Yeah, let's call this episode, let's do some clickbait. We'll call this episode 1,000 Degree Knife versus versus our self-respect and dignity.
Yeah, versus fat woman dropping stomach on man. Jesus Christ, I can't believe
that. Yeah, fuck your story. I want to talk about that.
Oh my God, it's so weird. But a while ago, this guy's cat died.
Yeah, this is kind of an old story, but it's still cool.
Well, the thing is like there's a little bit of an update on it. It's his dead cat, and he turned it into a drone because I guess he loves it that much. I don't know. To me, it looks like he put it in a position just so he could fuck it. I don't know. But he's from I forget where the fuck he's from. But his next thing is he's going to make a helicopter out of a cow.
That better be a damn powerful motor.
Yeah, and there's a picture of him. And see the guy next to him? I think the guy holding the cat is the owner. But the guy next to him, he actually hired like an engineer to do this. Like he got serious about this. Like he just wasn't like, oh, I'm going to do this in my spare time. He actually hired some engineer to do it. And there's just pictures. It looks so freaky. I'm going to have nightmares about this. Look at that fucking thing. Would you ever do that to your dead cat? You have a couple cats, don't you?
Yeah. I don't know. I'd lease them out to the Chinese food place.
Oh, my God. I thought I was about to sneeze there.
A buddy of mine who unfortunately is in a position where he won't be able to watch this show. But,
I think I know who I'm talking about.
We're not going to name names. I got to send that motherfucker a letter.
Yeah.
Anyway, I really do. But anyway, his dad had brought home a rabbit one time as a pet, and they named it Supper.
Oh, my God. That is so funny, dude. That is so funny.
I thought that was fucking hilarious.
Yeah, that is pretty cool. Like, that is
rabbit's
awesome.
Name, Supper.
I remember that. I don't know why this reminds me of it, but my mom was telling me this story the other day. When she was younger, she was eating with her family and everything like that, and they were bringing meat out and everything, and her dad was just trying to tease her, and he was like, you know that's cow, right? And my you know, mom's young. She's like, nuh-uh. And she, like, she's younger. She's just eating it. She doesn't know it's cow. And then she, like, found out that she's actually eating animals, and she, like, freaked.
You know, my kids know. I told them from the get-go.
Yeah. I just think that's funny. Like, I remember being younger, and I don't think I ever remember not eating animal.
Yeah, I mean, one time I was driving and we hit a deer, and it was a young deer, and we hit it right in the head, like, and basically snapped his neck and killed it.
How old were you? Oh, you were
no, I'm. Oh, this you were was a couple adult. Years ago.
Oh, okay.
driving, and we hit it in the neck, and it snapped his neck. It jumped out from the woods, and you know, committed caricide. Bambicide. And so I'm on my way home, and called up my stepdad, who's got a pickup truck, and I said to him, like, hey, I hit this deer, you know. And he's like, hey, is it still good? And I'm like, yeah, I didn't break the ribs or nothing. It's just in his head. So we picked it up and fucking threw a tag on it and got it processed.
Yeah, fuck
and
it.
The kids knew that we were eating what we ran over.
Yeah, I know. That's the thing. You took that pretty well, but I'd be like, you killed Bambi.
Well, I had a talk with him and explained to him, and I think that's the point when I explained, like, look, this is animals.
Yeah.
We always do it. Like, you know, hot dogs are things that had faces once.
Yeah,
and you know what? They took
dogs.
It pretty good.
Yeah, I love hot dogs. I don't care what the fuck's in them.
Everybody always says, oh, you don't know what's in that. Oh, yes, I absolutely
and
do.
And it's fucking
it's
delicious.
It's all the leftover bullshit. They put it in a centrifuge until all the bones are sorted out, and they turn it into slime. And they put it in a package and they cook it.
Yeah.
And I think they are delicious.
Yeah, and I even saw like videos of where they don't even actually really cook it afterwards. They speed through the processor so fast they cook while they do it.
Yeah, they don't boil them, but they cook.
It fucking flies through that thing and it's going at such fast speeds that it cooks it while it's doing it, yeah.
Interesting little tidbit. You know why there's a slit in there? That's where they cut the casings off.
Oh, really?
Yeah, okay. That's why all hot dogs have that slit down there.
Yeah, I know. And people are like, oh, sausage is disgusting. What's that casing? I'm like, they used to use intestines from sheep as casings for sausage.
Yeah, they call it natural casing. I love natural casing.
So it's actually better, you know. It's not, you know, sheep poop, but I don't care. I'll still eat them. Like Scrapple. Fuck it.
Oh, yeah, I love Scrapple.
Scrapple's just everything. I think that's just a Pennsylvania thing. Don't quote me on that.
Well, it's more popular here than elsewhere.
Yeah, but it's just everything from a pig leftover just put into a loaf.
What's head meat?
Yeah, basically. Yeah, they take everything from the head and they put it in this loaf pan and then they cook it and then you cut it.
And it's a bunch of cornmeal and spices and it's pretty tasty.
It's fucking delicious. It's sort of like sausage, sort of.
Well, I think anything like that's really considered a sausage.
Yeah, basically, just any kind of meat.
just animal mash.
Yeah, then I like it with, like, I don't cook it all the way. I like it a little tender in the side, and then you pour some maple syrup over it. Oh,
I eat it with mustard.
Oh, really?
You know what's good? Fried up, both sides good and crispy. Put it on a rye bread with a couple slices of onion and
lost
mustard.
Me at the rye bread.
You don't have to do rye, but I like rye.
Sourdough
would be good too.
Oh yeah, fuck yeah. Sourdough makes the best French toast. We're like all getting like Paula Deen right now.
Well, we've both spent many years cooking for a living, so this may occasionally devolve into
actually we're on cooking, the 15th episode, and I'm surprised it took us this long to talk about cooking.
I actually plan on one of these days doing a, you know, we'll do a recipe one of these days on the live on the show.
Yeah, we should actually. I just had some people. I waited on a table. They were from Connecticut, and we have this new. It's called the Gridiron Grinder, and Pennsylvania is one of the only states that call hoagies or subs hoagies.
I refuse to say that word. It sounds stupid.
I know it does, but I love it.
I call them subs like the rest of the country.
Yeah, and up north in Connecticut and stuff like that, they call them grinders. So he was all excited. He's like, oh, you have grinders here? And I'm just thinking, I'm like, it's the same thing. It's just called something different. But he was all excited.
I came up with that name. Thank you.
Did you? Yeah.
Trying to come up with a way to market it. I figured it's football season.
Yeah, I don't know.
And go Steelers! Motherfuckers are in the playoffs.
Yeah, I heard they're playing Miami. I didn't even know Miami was doing good.
Yeah, they're doing all right this year. Huh. Not terrible.
Yeah, Miami. I think the Texans made it.
I can't believe the Steelers made it. I can't believe the Steelers beat out fucking Baltimore. Baltimore started out with a hot streak and just kind of shit the bed.
I know. I didn't think Steelers were going to make it. They lost like four in a row that one time, and I was like, what the fuck,
yeah,
dude?
Yeah, I thought this was going to be a rebuilding year, you know, get the new young guys on the same page. But, man, they pulled it out of their ass. So
yeah, I guess when Ben Roethlisberger got hurt, I think that's when they lost a couple of those games in a row.
Well, yeah, that's because Landry Jones is a bitch.
Yeah, I can't believe Ben doesn't get hurt more. He's so tall and lanky, like he's just
gonna... lanky nothing, he's just a big dude.
Well, his stepdad, my friend Ron, like he saw him at the zoo, Pittsburgh Zoo, and Ron's what, 6'3", something like that?
Oh yeah, he's taller than both of us.
Yeah, Ben just towered.
Oh, I'm short.
What? Jay, I can't believe you just said that.
I'm short. I saw him, he's just a big man.
He's taller than me. I'm sorry.
I'm 5'5", yuck it up.
I'm sorry.
You know, in any other country, I'd be considered normal.
Oh, that's true. That's true. I seen this video where this guy got his girlfriend his dick in a box for Christmas. And she's like, I thought you were going to buy me a bigger present than that. And he gets all pissed off and he storms off.
That's hilarious.
And he walks back in. He goes, you know, this is an extra large in China. And just storms off.
That is the only appropriate response to that present. Just, I know. I thought you were going to get me something bigger.
Yeah, I know.
That's
only
appropriate.
I probably would have curled in the corner or cried or something like
that. I'd take that lady out to dinner. I'd laugh my ass off and be like, that's it? You're getting a steak dinner. Come on. Yeah. Let's go.
I'd be like, bitch. Yeah, that would probably be horrible when your girlfriend looks to eating steak more than, you know, having sex with you because the steak's bigger than your penis.
Ask my wife how that feels.
Oh, Jesus. We don't need sound effects. We got our voices.
Sorry. Yeah, you know, hey, might not be big, but he's a fighter.
Yeah, he's a fighter.
He's a fighter.
Hey, that's what women say. You know, it's not really the size, but I think that's full of shit.
Yeah, I've always heard it's not really the size of the boat, but the motion of the ocean. Yeah, but here's the deal. You're not getting to fucking China on a tugboat.
Yeah, I know. That's true, dude. That's fucking... I've never heard that before. That's pretty good.
Ex-girlfriend of mine actually said that, but not about me, thankfully.
Not about you.
I'm like a tripod.
Oh, that's pretty good. Mine just looks like a tuna can.
A tuna can. Yeah. Ain't 3 inches around, 1 inch long.
Ain't lengthy, but it's got some girth. God, these meds are kicking my ass.
Don't blame it on the meds. You're just as goofy to begin with. That's why we do this.
No, I'm so lightheaded right now. Like, I'm trying to finish this beer, and I'm just like...
As sick as you are, I thought for sure I'd be doing all the talking today.
No, I texted him this morning when I first woke up, and I was so congested. I'm like, Jay, can you bring me drugs? I don't care what you got. And he's like, I'll bring something. And I took two of them, and I don't know what they're doing to me.
They're basically DayQuil.
Yeah, but DayQuil makes me shaky.
Oh, good.
Yeah, for some reason, DayQuil. But I'm not the only one. I was talking to another person the other day. They said DayQuil makes them shaky, too.
I don't have that problem. NyQuil makes me hallucinate.
Yeah, I remember. You should tell people about your story.
All right. Well, when I was a teenager, and this is back in the day before everybody and their brother had a cell phone, so I had the house phone. So I fell asleep, and I was all on NyQuil, and a movie I like came on, so I was watching it, and I stayed up a little longer than I should have and fought it. So
what makes it bad is when you fight NyQuil. I walked into a wall one time.
Yeah, so I went up and I went to bed, and I remember my buddy calls me, as he was wont to do in the middle of the night from time to time. So I pick up the phone and I talk to him. I have a full-on conversation. Now, we were talking back and forth to one another, and then when I opened my eyes to hang up the phone, there was no phone there. Yeah, so it was like a little bit of.
Did you take the recommended dosage?
Yes, I did. I took the recommended dosage, but I stayed up because Army of Darkness came on. I had to finish watching that
movie. I got a bone to pick with you.
Yeah, they used to play that on regular TV all the time.
Hey, like maybe TBS. Just the regular dosage makes you trip, because I know people. I used to work at a grocery store, and there'd be numerous times where I'd walk into the bathroom, and you'd walk in, and there's just boxes of Robitussin all over the floor.
Yeah, that's.
They didn't even throw it away. They just open it, chug it real quick, throw it on the floor, just run the fuck out.
That's that Tussin, dog.
Yeah. I've done a lot of fucked up shit in my life, and I've never done that.
I just never done the drug thing. I smoked a little weed back in the day, and you know what? It doesn't even do anything for me.
Yeah.
Like, I guess it affects different people differently. For me, it makes me tired and hungry.
I know.
Well, I got news for you. I'm tired and hungry enough. I don't need help with that.
I know. I just get, I smile for, an hour straight, and then my cheeks get so sore, it makes me tired, and I go to bed.
You know, I bet you we're disappointing our audience right now, who thought for sure that this show was produced by copious amounts of marijuana.
No, dude. No, someone told me that yesterday. They're like, Casey, are you on drugs? I go, no, I don't do, I haven't done drugs since I was, 16. Like, I just don't.
You know, what are you, 32 now?
Yeah, unfortunately.
Hey, shut up, I'm older than you.
I know, but it just sucks. Yeah, but you have your life together. Shit, you have kids. You can build, couch forts with them. What do I got?
I do. One day I texted Casey a picture of the couch fort because I know you'd think it was pretty bitching.
Yeah, fuck yeah.
He did think it was bitching, too.
I put a little sign up, no girls allowed.
Yeah. Except for their girls. So. Yeah,
no Mariah Carey's. Diva.
This beer sucks.
I know. I can't taste it. Whatever, dude. I thought, I got coffee, water, and beer here. It all tastes the same to me. Just nope. Can't taste anything. Well, whatever.
Hey, you want to hear something funny?
What's up?
So there's this dude, man. He was all fucking, speaking of drugs, he was all methed out and shit. he storms into a McDonald's, and he demands that the workers turn off the Christian music playing. And here's the funniest part. He's like a white redneck dude. Look at it here.
Oh, my God, yeah. I like his face. He's like, what's up?
Yeah, I'd show you a picture, but I didn't send it to Casey ahead of time, so fuck you.
Got an extra value meal.
Yeah. He began cursing at the customers' employees and saying that they should play some Muslim and Hindu music, too.
Oh, my
God. He was mad about the Christian music, but he's not like...
Do Muslims even celebrate Christmas?
I know.
Yeah,
it's the birth of Christ. Why would they?
Like, what a fucking jackass.
Well, it's not even... Here's the thing, though. It's not even like he was making a point. A redneck
got politically correct. I can't believe it.
It's not even that. It's really not. The problem is he was all methed out.
I know, but, is that what meth does? Is that why everyone's so politically correct these days? Because they all do meth and it makes you politically correct?
No, meth makes you slowly rot away.
Yeah, that's true.
Not as bad as a crocodile. Crocodile shit.
Oh, yeah. Coming out Russian of heroin or whatever they call it.
It's nickname. Crocodile.
Yeah, there's so many names for it. Russian heroin, crocodile heroin, all that. Oh, yeah. Oh,
yeah, it
makes your skin rot off.
Yeah, where you inject it, the sites, it just rots. People have bones exposed. You don't go to that shit until you have already gotten to the point where you've accepted you're going to die, so you just need your fix until you get there.
Yeah, maybe that's what I'm going to do if I ever find out I get cancer or anything. Maybe I'll just try every drug. Just whatever. I'm laying there in my deathbed.
You have such a positive outlook on life.
Dude, life fucking sucks. Everyone knows it. I just fucking admit it. Life is all about going through shit. Oh, exciting moment.
Ladies, he's single.
Exciting moment. Oh, shit again. Exciting moment. Oh, shit again. No, I'm not the only one. Someone described life as like an ocean, And it's like just every wave's going to hit you, and then you're just waiting in between the next wave to hit you again. That's just the way life is. Life sucks.
Can you believe nobody put a ring on this yet?
I even say that. No, I stay single, motherfuckers. Because I even said, I'm like, I am a miserable piece of shit. It is not fair for me to put this on someone else.
I like them spirit fingers.
No, that's actually funny. I went to a wedding for my cousin in New Mexico, and that reminds me of jazz hands. His wife is actually a jazz-sized instructor. That's crazy.
The fucking what's his name, Richard Simmons style.
Oh yeah,
somebody putting voodoo curses on him, locking him in his house,
putting voodoos on the vaginas to get him locked in. We got to do a cover up on that story.
I doubt I'll ever find any kind of.
There might be. I don't know. We should do unsolved mysteries. You remember that they'd talk about something, and then weeks later, it'd be like, "Wadom update." And that guy, what was his name? He'd be like,
oh, John
man.
Walsh.
I used to love that in Current Affair. Do you remember Current Affair?
Current Affair, I remember.
He used to that triangle would come in, woo, woo, ding, or whatever it made. I can't make
still, though, Cops takes oh, the game. Yeah, I still, it. I love Cops.
Oh, yeah, Cops is amazing.
You know what I was watching today before I came over here was I Almost Got Away With It. Did you ever watch that?
No.
It's a show on the Discovery Channel, and it shows you these stories of these criminals who busted out of prison or committed some heinous crime, and they're running from the cops. And you end up, they're telling you all these stories, you end up rooting for them, kind of.
Yeah.
And it's like, oh, we almost got pulled over, but I gave the cop a fake name, and they let us get away. And you're like, yay! Like, hey, man, this guy's a scumbag.
Yeah, you're like, I'm a horrible person.
Why am I rooting for this guy?
I don't know. I'd probably root for it because I love chaos.
Yeah. Between you and Jason, you guys are both like some face paint away from being the Joker.
I know. I love. That's why me and Jason get along, because we both like seeing suffering and pain.
Of course, he got a woman to mellow him out. Now you're still just a miserable.
Yeah, I wonder how he got that woman. That's weird. I wonder who.
Yeah, you set him up.
I wonder who
hooked
him up.
Mr. Pimp over here,
I swear to God,
matchmaker.
Jason and Ashley, if you're watching this, if you guys get married, this will be the third couple I've hooked up that will get married.
Oh, yeah, no pressure, though.
No, I think it's already in the air. When I'm around him, I get this vibe that they're going to get married.
Well, if he wasn't planning on proposing, now she's going to make him, you idiot.
No, she's already got him by the balls. Oh, he's in a trap.
Trapped under ice. Jason's balls are in a little person, little purse next to her. He has to ask for
Jason
permission.
Jason Comedy
to take
Hour. Oh, I got to sneeze. Uh oh. Oh wait, I think I'm good. All right. Oh, sorry. I can't. That's how lightheaded I am right now. I knew I had the sniffle, and I tried to turn my head after I did it. Oh, this is a bad day. But, yeah, if you get married, you're the third couple I've set up. Yeah, I think, yeah. Actually, one of the couples was my mother. I hooked my mom and this guy up. They got married. He proposed to her, 2 weeks later. Do I know how to hook people up, or do I know how to hook people up?
Yeah, and that same reason why his stepdaughter is your ex-girlfriend and why Thanksgiving's uncomfortable for you.
Yeah, but that's okay. I don't have to see that cunt anymore. I fucking hate her. I'm sorry. She's an evil person. She's such a bitch. I don't know if I ever mentioned this before, but she was such a cunt to my mom. She used to put bleach in her hairspray and shit. It's a whole nother story.
Well, if your mom ever wanted to be blonde, that might have been okay.
I know, and that's the thing.
Didn't she try to poison her plants?
Yeah, she put pine sol in my mom's plants. My mom moves in, and all her plants are living, and a week later, they're all dying. She's like, what the fuck are my plants dying for? She goes over and smells them, and they smell like pine sol, and she finds out her stepdaughters were putting pine sol in her plants. She has horrible daughters, and I'm sorry, George, if you ever see this, but your daughters are horrible. They're just so fucking bad. There's three of them, and they just hate my mother. I don't know if they're jealous or what, but they did so much shit to her. They put pine sol in their plants, bleach in their hairspray. This one time, it was her birthday. And for her birthday, the birthday cards she got, she put them up in her house and everything like that. Well, they didn't like that, so they came down and took them all down and put them in the trash can.
How'd they get along with you?
They didn't.
They just ignored your presence?
We ignored each other.
Huh.
It was like, hey, parts of me was inside you. We're just going to ignore
you. I'm not talking about that one girl in particular, but how about the other one? There's other ones in there?
Oh, yeah. Three of them? The oldest one is the worst. She's just, oh, Like, just god awful.
Like, do you talk to any of them anymore?
No, no, no. The younger one, she was cool. Me and her actually got along really well. But the one I dated and the older one were just fucking god awful. They were the ones that, like, poisoned my mom's plants and shit like that. And just, I don't know.
That's some pretty shitty stuff to do.
I know. They were horrible people. And people wonder why I have a negative outlook on life. I just see it all the time.
Well, you know, it's up to you to change that outlook.
No.
No. That's the response. Just no.
No, I'm like, I'm used. I'm abused. I'm damaged. It's like when a condom breaks, you can't repair it, Jay. It just doesn't work.
You know what that sounds like to me?
What?
An excuse.
No. Did you ever try to duct tape a condom? Ain't gonna work, buddy.
No, but you can always go to the pantry and get yourself a hefty bag.
Hefty, hefty, hefty.
Wimpy, wimpy, wimpy.
Oh, man. Oh, God. I know. Dude, I've been having a sneeze come for like 5 minutes now. I just know it's coming.
Look up at the ceiling.
What's that do?
I don't know. It just makes you sneeze usually when you got one coming.
Does it?
Yeah.
It's not really doing anything.
All right, well, okay. Maybe it doesn't work for everybody. It
just makes me feel more lightheaded. But like we were talking about true crime and stuff like that, since we've been doing this podcast, I've been, you know, getting more into the podcast world, and there is a huge, huge following for true crime podcasts. And I got to start listening to them and see what the fucking fuss is about.
Yeah, it's not my thing.
Yeah, have you ever listened to one? Have you ever, like, heard
one?
Well,
no, because I'm not really interested in, you know, like, your true crime or your detective stories. It's just not my thing.
Yeah, that's awesome.
The only detective story I like is Batman.
Batman. The new Batman Lego movie's coming out. I can't wait for that. That
yeah, chances are it'll probably be better than Christian Bale. Yeah, I said it.
I know, I didn't think he was a good Joker. I mean, Batman. See, that's the thing. I don't even know what character he played. I know someone did a YouTube video of him and Bane trying to have a conversation, and that's all it was.
I'm sure.
And that's the thing, when the original film came out or whatever like that, the Bane voice we heard, that was the second time they redid it. It was
you mean evil. Stupid Sean Connery wasn't the original?
It was worse.
This is Gotham Reckoning! Oh, my God. Like, I love Tom Hardy. He's great, but not in that role.
Yeah. They had to redo his voice. Like, they had it all edited and everything, and then they were like, dude, we can't understand him. So they had to redo all of his voice, and that was the second take.
That's the voiceover.
Yeah, I can't imagine how bad it was before that.
I love how some journalist asked him, like, oh, did you do steroids like that? And he responded, like, the fuck do you think?
See, that's what
it's
like.
You go from, you know, a relatively decently built man to a fucking giant. What do you think?
See, that's what I like. I like honesty. That's why I like Jennifer Lawrence. She's just like, she doesn't give a fuck. Dude, she hates being a celebrity. Like,
she does not. Oh, part of that's an act.
She fucking hates it. Dude, you can
part of that's an act.
No, I don't think so, dude.
Part of that's that down home girl next door thing.
She's a down girl home. That's why I like her, dude.
Bitch can win the Hunger Games, but she can't climb up the Oscar stairs. Fuck that.
Dude, she was wearing 9-inch heels, dude. 9-inch heels with a fucking...
Why would you bother? Wear sneakers and a tracksuit.
Because they get free shit, dude. She even, like, had this huge diamond ring on, and they were like, did you get that for free? She's like, does a bear shit in woods? And then she ordered McDonald's on the red carpet. She doesn't give a fuck, dude.
Yeah, if she didn't give a fuck, she'd show up in a fucking pair of Nikes and a goddamn tracksuit. I don't want to hear it.
Dude, I'm not saying she doesn't like the money. Who fucking does it, dude?
It's all an act. It's all a manufactured image.
It probably is.
Everything's a manufactured image.
I don't give a fuck, dude. Whatever. I just like honesty. If you're honest, you're fucking okay with me. Like the steroids thing. Like, what the fuck do you think?
Like Tom Hardy.
No, I was doing Richard Simmons and Buns of Steel videos for 9 hours. Like, what the fuck do you think?
He was great in the new Mad Max movie. It caught a lot of hate, but I was so excited to see that.
What did it get from the feminism bullshit?
No. You know that movie got the most hate from the alt-right jackasses who are like, oh, well, this whole movie is just a feminist propaganda. Like, dude, just because the main character was somebody other than Mad Max... Really, come on. Honestly, in most of the movies, the other character was more important. Like, look at The Road Warrior. The little kid was the most important character in that whole movie. Max was just somebody who was doing shit.
Hell, in most of the movies, I think his car's a more important character.
Yeah. Like, the only one where Max is really the main character is the original Mad Max, and it was when, you know, he just fucking lost his shit because he killed his kid and wife.
Yeah. I'll admit, I was a little, because they actually did hire a feminist producer or something like that. So I was like, ah, oh, come on. But then I watched it, and I was like, it's not that bad. Like, whatever.
That movie was badass.
Yeah, I thought it was good. I don't know. There's a lot worse movies out there with, like, this feminism, like, you know, agenda or whatever like that. Like, I was watching, what was that one movie with the police bunny or whatever like that?
Oh, I don't know.
There was a lot of fucking, like, feminism bullshit, and I was like, come on, dude. It was a really good movie, but I can't fucking remember it. She was a little fucking cop bunny.
Oh, are you talking about Zootopia?
Yeah.
I didn't even watch it.
Yeah, it was a really good movie, but they, like, threw this shit in there. It was just, like, this feminism bullshit. I was like, come on, man.
I'm all about equality, but not superiority.
Yeah, I'm going to start ranting about feminism again. I better shut the fuck up. I get so angry about it.
Yeah, I'm all for equality, but don't act like a superior.
Yeah. And that's the thing I hate. But I don't know. Whatever.
You know, I
believe... Moving on so I don't shank someone.
Fuck it.
No, go ahead. What were you saying?
I'm just saying, you know, if you want equal rights and shit like that, I'm all about it. But, you know, don't go there and say that there's two things you can't get away with doing with me. One, tell me you're better than me because you're of who you are, what fucking shit was you were born with between your legs.
Hey, now. There's, you know, more than
two. Did genders. I just gender? Yeah. Well,
how dare you genderize me?
Look, and that's another rant for another day, but or maybe it'll be today too. But you know, you can't tell me you're superior than me because you have a uterus,
mm-hmm.
Okay? And you can't tell me you're superior than me because you have a different color skin than I do. You can say you're equal, and I wholeheartedly agree with you, and you deserve every right. That doesn't mean that you get some sort of ridiculous fucking privilege.
I know, and I think that's why a lot of this stuff is failing. Like, a lot of women are abandoning feminism, just the word, because it's not...
Mm-hmm. Well, people are perverting it.
Yeah, people... It's turning into just a man-hating group that some guy broke their heart, so, you know, they're using something against people. Right. And it's just... Like, I told you this one day. This fucking feminist... I didn't think they were out here, but I saw one. She purposely did not hold the door open for me. Like, it was the most blunt, like, piece of shit thing I've ever seen. Like, she had hairy legs, short hair, just, you know, whatever. She had a tank top on, hairy armpits or whatever like that. I'm going up, and, like, I'm right behind her, so she probably thought I was a rapist because all men are rapists. And she opens the door, runs in real quick, turns around, shuts the door. Like, it was so obvious. I was like, wow. Like, and I was just like, it's so ridiculous.
Yeah, you're not superior.
And that's the thing. That's why people are starting to abandon this shit. You're acting superior. And it's just, that's not the way it works.
And the second point I want to make is you are no better if you're going to sit here and judge me based on what's between my legs or what color skin I have.
Mm-hmm.
If you sit here and say that, I'm the white devil or I'm a man, so I must be a rapist. I'm like, I'm sorry, you didn't take the time to get to know me.
Yeah, exactly.
Isn't that exactly what you're sitting there saying?
And that's what I'm saying. Like, the main downfall of rights movements right now that I see personally is how biased, like, you're being. Like, how hypocritical you're being. You're saying that, you know, this is important because of this person's rights, but in the same sense, you are not even recognizing other people's rights. Like, you're going full balls to the wall for your rights so much, you're not even considering other people's rights. You're being hypocritical. It's just...
Hell, it even moves beyond that.
Yeah, it's just... You're not even, like... Like I said,
you know,
like,
you want to cut your hair short and wear fucking flannel and raid my closet. You do you, I'll do me. But, you know, if you want to deserve to make the exact same pay that I do for the exact same job, sure. And if you want to say that I'm a fucking scumbag because I happen to have a dick and I like chicks.
Yeah.
Fuck you.
And
you're just a racist, bigoted piece of shit, just the same as the people you're calling out.
I know. And I just, like, and I see it a lot with, like, the Merry Christmas shit. Like, you should say Happy Holidays because it offends people. And it's just like, why can't you... But see, you're not appreciating that people are celebrating Christmas. So you're telling these people that do celebrate Christmas to stop doing what they're doing to help other people. So you're not... It's canceling out.
It's just oversensitive douchebags.
Yeah, you're not doing anything at all. You're being hypocritical that, oh, you're hurting these people's feelings. Well, you're not letting other people be other people. Like, people... You're not letting people be anybody anymore. You're just... And that's like, did you see James Hetfield left California?
No, I didn't.
They're like, dude, why'd you move? He's like, California boasts that they're the most unified, diverse people. But if you, the minute you don't think like them, you're a fucking piece of shit. He just can't stand it anymore. It's just,
well, it's just like, I can't speak for people, but I have to assume that if you are somebody and you say Merry Christmas to another person and a Jewish, that person turns out to be Jewish, I would imagine most people would be like, oh, thanks.
Yeah, whatever.
Or even just say, hey, I'm Jewish. And you know what that other person would probably say? Oh, I'm sorry. Happy Hanukkah.
Yeah, I know.
Because it's not trying to offend anybody to sit there and say, you're literally trying to be nice by saying it.
Yeah.
You are literally going out of your way to be nice by wishing somebody a happy holiday, whatever that holiday may be that you practice.
I know, and that's the thing. They're not even appreciating that someone is going out of their way just to say Merry Christmas.
Yeah.
It's called being polite.
Look outside your fucking bubble, because here's the deal. If you are sitting there and you say to a Jewish person, Merry Christmas, you are literally showing in the most definitive of terms that the fact that they are Jewish isn't important.
Yeah, exactly.
You're completely
exactly,
equal to
Jay.
Me.
Exactly.
It didn't even peg on my radar that you're Jewish and different from me in some way.
Exactly. And that's the thing. Like, everyone, it's just, it's too much.
If you would even slip to a blatantly obvious Muslim, Merry Christmas, and that person is offended, then they really should stop and reappreciate the fact that you have literally made the most open commitment that their religion or race really doesn't affect your thoughts of them as a person.
I know, and this probably has already happened, but I can't wait till the day where you're like, God bless you, because someone sneezes and they're like, how dare you?
Well, they already do that.
I know, probably. And it's just like, people are just so focused on political correctness. You're forgetting and losing the whole idea of human interaction.
People are so focused on their differences, they won't sit there and think about what brings us all together. We're all people.
I know. Like, when you say Merry Christmas or God bless you or something, it's just polite. It's being polite. It's human interaction. It's not, it's just, and people don't get that.
Yeah, I don't care if you're white, you're black, you're Muslim, you're Jewish, you're gay, you're straight. I don't care about any of that. As long as you're a decent human being, you're cool.
I know, dude. I don't give a fuck, dude.
I don't care if you're like a fucking, you know, toothless homeless guy. If you're cool, I'm cool with you. You know, hey, I got a story, speaking of the whole gay thing.
You know, if you're coming out to me, I'm not ready.
I have a wife and kids, for God's sakes.
A lot of people get married and then like 20 years later,
it's a
like,
sham.
Oh shit, I'm gay. I ain't gay.
I have an ex-girlfriend who I'm pretty sure she married a guy who's someday going to come out and disappoint her. That's neither here nor there.
And it happens all the time.
Yeah, anyway, well, moving on. Here's a little funny story. Back when I was in high school, you know, this kid I knew all through high school and used to play in bands with and hung out with, comes out to me one day. He says, hey, I'm gay. And I say, okay. I was a little weirded out. You know, 16 years old, you don't really know how to process that.
Yeah, you're just surprised.
I was a little, I didn't know what to say. He goes, oh, don't worry, I don't find you attractive. And I'm like, okay. And then later on, I'm thinking, hey!
Yeah, motherfucker!
Yeah. Like, damn, I'd like to think if I was gay, I could at least get a date. I didn't know what to think.
That's pretty funny. Like, don't worry, I don't find you attractive.
I'm like, damn, yeah. Like, at first I was all relieved, and then as the more I thought about it, I'm like, damn, that motherfucker just slighted me.
Hey, men have types too, dude. I don't know. Those motherfuckers! No, but I had a gay guy explain to me, though. He's like, when you come out to people, it's really hard at first because for some reason, when you come out to men, they think that automatically you want to have sex with them. And I'm like, why? That makes no sense. He goes, yeah, I know. Because imagine, you know, me sitting in a room, or imagine a woman sitting in a room with all guys around her. She doesn't want to fuck every single one of those guys. It's the same thing with gay men. Like, say there's a gay guy in a room full of guys. He doesn't want to fuck all the gay men. I was like, yeah, exactly. So, like, if a gay guy ever comes out to you, it's probably not like that.
Yeah, but if they sit there and say, that's okay, I don't find you attractive. Yeah. You have the right to be offended.
Yeah, men have standards, too. Oh, sneeze. Oh, God. Oh, God. I better feel better next week because I'm like, I'm giving it all I got to not sneeze.
Your face is getting all red and shit.
Oh, I feel
probably like, can't even tell on the camera. It has a sort of greenish tint.
Yeah, I feel like fucking AIDS, dude. Like, I just, oh my God. But we're making it. We're making it. Push it to the limit. I'm making it, baby.
So, right. You got anything else you want to talk about?
Yeah. I was thinking the other day about blue laws. they call them blue laws. I don't know what other names are for them, but there's a bunch of laws in the United States that they never actually really got rid of. And I have a list here that I'm just going to read some off.
Some of these wacky ones that never got off the books.
Yeah, I have no
idea. Oh, these are fun.
And the thing is to come up with these must have happened.
Well, there had to be a reason, yeah.
And because some of them are just so off the wall, you're like
well, you know what? I'm going to tell you a little secret about some of these that are out there. One of these lists and things like that they have these, a lot of times what it is a very vague law and somebody comes with a very specific scenario it'd fit for.
Right.
But I don't know if that's any of the ones you have here.
No,
but
they're actually blue laws that are still ingrained into our law system on paper. It's just no one follows them anymore.
Right. Okay.
Right. Number one, I got 10 of them here. I put something in for Pennsylvania because, of course, Pennsylvania's on here.
Yeah, I think we have one that involves a whole, well, I don't know if this is on your list, but if a car comes by a horse and spooks it, you have to actually dismantle the car and put it behind a bush until the horse passes.
That's pretty funny, actually.
So we have 11.
No, I'm a sick fox, so these all have to do with sex.
Of course they do. I should have known.
All right, this would just fucking suck. Oral sex is illegal in 18 states, including Kansas and Utah.
Well, I'm not surprised by Utah.
Yeah, I know.
Fucking sexually repressed Mormons.
A little weird out there.
Number two. Look at me marginalizing people. God damn it.
I feel like David
I'm
Letterman.
I'm a cis scumbag.
I feel like David Letterman here with the top 10 countdown.
Number two.
It is illegal in 18 states for a man to have an erection that shows through his pants. That should be illegal in every fucking state. Especially around playgrounds.
I know a lot of people in high school that have problems with that.
Yeah. I have a friend actually that wears sweatpants to strip clubs.
I know a lot of people who do that. We call those people scumbags.
Yeah. I'm just mad because I didn't think of it. Number three, it is illegal in Willowdale, Oregon for men to talk dirty to their wives during intercourse.
Oh, I'm breaking that law constantly.
But it's okay when she's doing the dishes. Clean those dishes, bitch.
Yeah, that's right. You scrub that filth. Scrub that filth.
That's like when a wife's like, I want you to talk dirty to me. You go into her ear and be like, kitchen, living room, kitchen, bathroom.
Laundry.
Yeah, I don't know why I'm single. All right, number five. In Dyersburg, I guess that's how you say it. In Dyersburg, Tennessee, it is illegal for a lady to call a gentleman for a date. That would just suck, man. Like, what would you do with whores? Like, you couldn't be a whore. And whores are great.
Well, no, the men are calling you generally for whores.
But that's rape these days. But anyways, number six, in Connersville, Wisconsin, it is illegal for a man to shoot off a gun while his female partner is having an orgasm.
You know that was one guy who got that law in the books.
I know, too.
His neighbor's hanging out the window. God damn it, Johnny, we know!
I know, and that's what I was like, how did this law get made? It was some guy bragging. Because back in the day, female orgasms weren't that popular, or so they tell us. So it was like, when she had one, you probably let everyone know. I just can't believe, like, that would take some time.
Woo!
Like, what if she's faking it? Do you shoot off blanks?
No, that's after you had a vasectomy.
Yeah.
I got to go for my consultation for that pretty soon.
Oh, that's right. Are you getting it?
Unless they tell me that I'm probably going to get, like, crotch ghosts or something.
Crotch ghosts.
I don't know.
You fucking... You could have nightmares about this.
I'm a little worried about the whole thing, but...
I just heard it. You feel a little tug and it's over.
Yeah, there are possible complications because I'm a fucking sadistic idiot and I decided to look them up.
Oh, of course you did.
I think I'm gonna vlog it.
You should, dude. Put it.
I think I'm gonna vlog
your vasectomy on the show.
I'm obviously not gonna show shit, but you know, I might talk about it, you know. Well, anyway.
Well, don't they clip it above your deck? Isn't it a tube above your deck or something near your stomach?
No.
Huh.
It's your. They cut you open your scrot.
Oh, okay. Yeah, fuck you.
I'm not filming the procedure.
Have fun with that, buddy.
All right. Anyway, moving on.
I thought they cut you like part of your stomach. But just
that's if they castrate you.
Yeah. Number seven, in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, it is illegal to have sex with a truck driver inside a toll booth. How many times?
Okay.
And that's Pennsylvania. That's happened.
I'm sure.
A lot.
I drove a truck for 6 months. I've seen shit.
Yeah, he saw a lot lizard washing her vagina with diesel fuel, but
well, no. it was a puddle next to a pump with fuel in it.
Oh my god, I gotta sneeze again. God, I hate my life. There it is.
Oh, there. Finally broke the seal. You feel better now.
God, I feel horrible. All right. Number 8. Having sex with a porcupine is illegal in Florida. Of course, because it's Florida.
Okay.
Number 9. In Utah, it is illegal to marry your first cousin before the age of 65. Why? 65. Why? Is that like retirement age?
I guess.
Oh, man.
So they don't want you, you know, fucking them for benefits, I guess?
I guess. I don't fucking know. Number 10 here, last one. In Washington State, it is illegal to have sex with a virgin under any circumstances, including the wedding night. However, sex with animals is perfectly legal for men in Washington State as long as they weigh less than 40 pounds.
So you can fuck really, the cat, but not your own wife.
Yeah, these are really detailed. Like, how many times did that happen?
I don't know. It's another one. It's like one guy has seen it.
Yeah. Ooh. Did you hear my nose?
Was that your nose?
Yeah. Oh, my God.
That was your chair squeaking or something.
No, that was my nose. Oh, man. This is horrible.
Jesus Christ, Casey.
Go ahead. Cover next thing. I got to blow my nose.
Well, I got one that's kind of funny. So there's apparently a Japanese husband who went 20 years without speaking to his wife. She upset him.
He must be a very happy man.
Anyway, here's the reason. He was jealous because she was paying more attention to the children than him. No way.
Children need a little bit of attention.
No way. So he literally did not speak to her for 20 years. They continued to be married, continued to live in the same house, but didn't speak to her for 20 years. Sorry.
God, that's fucking commitment, dude. That is fucking commitment.
Like, and the wife was persistent about trying to make conversation with him, but has only received a grunt or a nod in response for 20 years.
He's like caveman. Wonder if they still had sex.
That's a good question.
Like, yeah, he probably got hookers. Japan's weird. Oh, caveman. Oh, knock overhead, take back the cave.
So they managed, the children finally managed to get them to speak to one another on a Japanese television show, and they set up a date in the park, and they're sitting in the park bench.
Oh, look at all the kids. They're like, are they going to do it?
Yeah, look how happy they are. Anyway, it goes, their meeting was arranged in the park where they had their first date as their emotional children watched on. Oh, excuse me. Somehow it's been a while since we talked. And then the husband goes, you were so concerned about the kids. Yumi, up until now, you've endured a lot of hardship. I want you to know I'm grateful for everything. So he's grateful for everything, but he didn't speak to her for 20 years.
So did she just realize after 20 years it was because of the kids?
I have no idea.
Like, that would suck if you didn't know for 20 years, and then all of a sudden he's like, you paid more attention to kids. She's like, that's what this is about?
Oh, it gets better.
There's four of them there, so she probably was pretty busy with
them. Yeah. He later explained that he's been given the cold shoulder out of jealousy for the attention and care the children get. He said on the show, I was kind of jealous. I was sulking about it. There's no going back now, I guess.
Oh, my God.
That's, like, the biggest shithead. Like, Mariah Carey, after her fucking shit, posted an Instagram photo that said, shit happens. That's an appropriate shit happens. Yeah. This is, I didn't talk to you for 20 years. Oops.
Why'd they stay married? I don't get that's love, I guess. I don't know.
I don't know if it's love. It's just they have a different culture than we do.
Could you not talk to your wife for 20 years?
Could I not talk to my wife for 20 years? I'm sure she would love that, but she'd be okay with it. I wouldn't.
Is she ever going to come on the show?
I don't know.
I know last week you were saying you were trying to get her.
I'll wheedle her onto it one of these days.
Like the Pokemon Weedle? Weedle!
No, Weedle just means to continue to like bug somebody until they finally break down and go, fine!
It's like rapist.
That generally is a lot faster.
Yeah, it is. They say in New York City, don't yell rape because people will join. You're supposed to yell fire. No, that's a true thing. That's a true thing. Like, I'm not making that up. Like, yeah.
Well, then.
That's the world we live in. That guy's awesome, though. Like, he still loves her, but he won't talk to her. Like, and that's the thing. That's what relationships are like, basically. It's basically how much do you love the person to deal with all the hate? Like, that's why I don't understand relationships. I just don't, because today it seems like it's more that a person gets into a relationship to make themselves happy, where you're supposed to get in a relationship to make the other person happy. And I just don't see a lot of that anymore.
I don't know if it's quite that. I mean, you got to have sort of a 50-50 take on it.
I know, but I don't know. I think you're supposed to be in a relationship to, you know, help someone else out and, you know, build something off of it. And because people are like, I don't know. I just see a lot of people break up for the dumbest reasons. I'm like, well, that's what you broke up for?
Nobody's willing to put the work in anymore.
I know, dude.
I mean, Amanda and I fight. I mean, God.
Oh, you made it through the election. You guys are golden.
Barely.
You guys are golden. If you can make it through that election, if anyone can, you're golden. And we're not going to talk about it because I am done.
unless it just becomes the only thing that's going on in the world, then we'll be kind of forced. But other than that.
Yeah, I'm not going to talk about it for 20 years.
All right, people. Well, if you're liking what we do, make sure you hit the subscribe button, and it would really help us out if you hit the thumbs up button down below there on YouTube. Yep. Share us with your friends. Tell everybody about the show. We know it's hard to watch for an hour, but we're glad to have you every week. So please come in, share with your friends, share with anybody you think might like the show.
Yeah, and please, if we look this stuff up for ourselves to talk about, like what me and Jay were really looking forward to, and one of the reasons why we started this was to talk to other people.
Yeah, if you got something you'd like us to discuss, yeah, please, like just send us a comment.
Like, send us articles, send us anything you want to talk about. Like, we just think this is interesting stuff to us. We want to know what's interesting to you guys.
Yeah, hit us up on Twitter at Hostile Opinions. You can find us on Google+. You can find us on Facebook.
Yeah, even, like, just post stuff on, like, because I'd like to do a bit sometime where we just talk about what people are doing on Twitter. Like, if you want us to talk about something, I don't know, is there a crazy sex lunatic run through your fucking, you know, neighborhood naked, you know, beating off cats? Send it to us. Yeah. Let us know.
All right, everybody. Like, subscribe, hit us up at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. Thank you to our patrons. You make the show possible. And everybody, we love you. Have a great week.
Love you all.
This has been Openly Hostile Opinions.
Good night.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.